One of the systems I'm interested in is marine mineral deposits on the seafloor, such as ferromanganese nodules and crusts. And I want to understand how trace metals accumulate to very high concentrations in these deposits. Trace metals are very important because they can play essential biological roles for many organisms. The best known example is iron in aqueous systems, but they can also be toxic. And of course, in our industries, in our modern industries, we need many of those rather rare elements, especially in modern technologies that help to combat climate change. My samples all have been retrieved during different research cruises with big ocean-going vessels. So typically we go out to sea for 4 to 6 weeks and we take underwater robots or other TV grabs and other sampling gear with us that allow us to collect the ferromanganese nodules and the ferromanganese crust from the seafloor. Our assumption is that there is a redox reaction that is responsible for this high accumulation of thallium, and we are trying to find evidence for this by using the ID26. In natural samples, it's very challenging to measure the metal speciations because these minerals are a mix of all kinds of different metals, and there is always one fluorescence line that interferes with our element of interest. EBS made this special analysis on natural samples possible because otherwise we wouldn't have been able to resolve the thallium from the arsenic line.